All right, before I begin, I also want to let everyone know that I have membership levels. All right, consider joining. You'll get early access to videos. I think they'll be even ad-free, so they'll most likely be ad-free. I think I'll make it ad-free since you're being a member to watch the early access videos. Different levels. One level has a shout out. I'll shout out and read your comments or questions. Another level is platinum level, where you or sponsors get to help me make video by directing me and making suggestions or requests for videos. All right, so let's continue with the laser dry firing. Hello everyone, welcome back. In this episode, I'm gonna be using the Laser Academy from Mantis. All right, so I've been exploring different laser dry fire apps. Recently, iTarget Pro kind of updated on my other phone, and I tried to check it out. And I have to tell you, I'm not impressed with the iTarget Pro. I also downloaded Strikeman laser app as well, but let me just get into the Mantis Laser Academy. Now, I'm supposed to get a code when I bought the Blackbeard, okay, the laser dry fire system for your AR rifles or your AR pistols, I got a coupon code. I'll try to put a picture of it somewhere. I'll block out the coupon code. But anyways, so I blocked out the coupon code and I try to use a coupon code for the unlimited. See where it says pro and everything? I tried to use it and it says it didn't work. So I'm going to probably contact Mantis, see what the problem is, you know, and see if I can get full access to the Mantis Laser Academy. Anyways, before I start, let me go into, there's only four that's available to me, and I logged in as a guest. So you can log in as a guest, or you could just sign up and create a profile. I did create a profile, but you can also log in as a guest. So open shooting, single target, okay. That's, you don't need a target. You don't need one of their own targets, and I'll try to show you. And then shoot from ready, guard low. I'll do those two in this video. The other one's bullseye five shot, and the dual single shot, you need their proprietary like targets with the QR codes up on the four corners. I'll try to see if I could get a picture somewhere online and see if I could just load it up here. That way I don't have to buy those. Anyways, so let's just go here. Let's go open shoot. I already got a target. Okay. I already have a target. And I've already kind of set it up here a little bit. I put it at 3 yards. There's not much to do. I have used it. I have to tell you, it's pretty good. You know, it's not too sensitive to light. If I just tap the circle, there's other things you can use, square, rectangle. But I like, you could either move it with your finger, and I'll show you, like, you can move it with your finger. All right. Or you can use this. You can use the little arrows. I like that to get more exact. And a circle, that's the best I've done with it. Let me see here. Trying to get into it perfectly. So you can actually increase and decrease the circle as well. You can actually pinch it with your finger, or you can use the plus and minus arrow. Okay. So, and before I start, I'm using the Blackbeard. And the issue with the Blackbeard is, you know, you have your optic or you have your sights, your iron sights, whatever you're using. There's usually a height over bore because obviously if you're doing it inside your house, you're not at 25 yards or 100 yards or whatever. So there's going to be that issue. Well, there's not a lot of apps, okay, that handle the height over bore issue. All right, the height over bore. All right. So that's why when you aim at that center target, you're going to be off a few inches. Your laser is going to be hit below a few inches, and then your target shows a laser hit below where you shot at, where you aimed at. Well, there's not a lot of apps that compensate for that. I mean, one of them is Laser Dry Fire Online that I've been kind of using, but this one here, the Mantis Academy, Laser Academy, it does compensate for that. Let me go into settings up on the upper right, and you'll have other things. You have a countdown 3 seconds. I guess you can change that if you want. Auto adjust camera. The camera will auto adjust, which is kind of nice. You get your ISO and some camera shutter speeds, so you get to control some of that. If you scroll up, you'll see that it has a ballistic offset, so you can actually manually control that, or if you push shoot to calibrate, all right, and then there's that. There's a looks like a target, the red target. Let me move that over where I want it to. So that's where I'm gonna shoot to calibrate. It could be a little bit lower. I wish they had the arrow thing, but I guess whatever. I guess it works. All right. I'm just gonna do that. All right, so I'm gonna take one shot. I'm gonna shoot right at the middle. All right, this laser is off. The Mantis laser is off. Because I've been using other apps that adjust for the height over bore, I don't really bother changing it because I just want to dry fire. So I leave it that way. I don't try to adjust it. I don't try to adjust the laser, okay? And I'm okay with it. I might adjust it later, but that's the difference. Height over bore, okay? So you got it's calibrated. I'm gonna apply it. All right, it's applied. All right. That's how easy it is. All right. Now, my height over bore has been zeroed because if you're indoor and you're shooting around, especially with an AR platform like this, okay, an AR platform, you're gonna have that issue. It's not like a handgun. So I'm gonna be training with the Mantis Blackbeard here because it's much more fun. So now I'm gonna go ahead and start. And this is just, you can shoot unlimited, there's no time. It's very basic, very simple. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and shoot, and I'm just gonna take my time. There's no time limit on this. So you can actually see the laser. What I like about the app is I think the camera sensitivity, how it adjusts, it is a lot better. I do think it's a lot better. You can actually see where the laser actually hit, but where I was aiming was right there, right in the middle. That's what I like about it. Oh, did it stop on me now? Okay, stop. Okay, well, some reason it stopped on me. That was weird. Okay, okay, so if after you're done, you can analyze your shot, but let's get out of it. Let's do it again. That was kind of weird. I don't know why it froze on me like that. Okay, let's try again. Oh no! Don't tell me this thing froze on me. It did. Wow, the app literally froze on me. Okay, let's see if I exit out and get back in. Okay. All right. Now I've already, it does, I do think it does save your settings and everything. Okay. All right, let's just start. And I do think it does save your settings. When you do get off target, I'll show you what I'm talking about. All right, because there's an offset, the where I hit shows as black because the laser hit off target, you know. but that's not where I'm, where the red might have a hollow sun red dot. So the hollow sun red dot is kind of, I'm hitting where the hollow sun red dot is aimed at, but because the laser is off target, it shows it as black. So awesome. I got another app. I have another app that I can use with the Mantis Blackbeard where it adjusts for the height over bore. Good job, Mantis. You're making a really good app here. Now, if only if my coupon code, my redeemable coupon code will work on this, I'm going to have to email Mantis or contact Mantis. Hopefully they could help me out and you know, I could get to a different type of training. A little bit something simpler, maybe easier, where most people have like a phone and a setup. You can do this. Do you need the targets? I don't know. Who knows? But anyways, I wanted to show you this. Another thing I do want to show you is that you may have to adjust the ISO or shutter speed, because I did notice, and I'll put a stop. All right, excellent. So, all right, it tells me my shots and everything. It gives you numbers, all that, your splits. I don't know what all these symbols mean. Okay, let's just get out of here. Okay, then if you go back here, it'll tell you your numbered shots. Okay, that's kind of cool. That's kind of cool. I will tell you that it does not keep up with my trigger pulls. Okay, and I'll show you. I'll give you an example here real quick. All right, I'm going to do a speed test here. So it doesn't keep up with the speed of the Blackbeard or the speed of your trigger finger. It does not keep up because I shot more than 19 shots. So anyways, let me go on to a different free part of the app. Shoot from guard or low ready. And it's a single shot. Okay, low ready. Oh, gotta push start.
Ready.
Okay, so that's what it looks like. It automatically goes into the stats. What I don't like about it is that I have to go over here and I have to touch it and I have to push it again. But it is free. Low ready. It didn't say ready. I was expecting to say ready. It didn't say that. One more time.
Ready.
Okay. Well, you get the idea. So those are the two free ones. Let me show you what the other ones look like real quick. And I think you basically need those paper targets with the QR codes on them. See, it says no target detected because they require their proprietary targets there. So it won't even let you start. This is a dual single shot, so if you want to play with someone, calibrating, and then it just splits the screen in half, but you need their proprietary targets to make it work. Anyways, I'm going to conclude this episode here. Mantis Blackbeard, if you want, safety checked because there's the battery in the magazine wheel, and there's the Blackbeard, the laser system in here. So I do like it. I'll try to see if I can redeem my coupon code for buying the Blackbeard, because the Blackbeard came with a coupon code to redeem with the Laser Academy. Anyways, so if you like this video, please like, share, comment. Let me know what you think of the Laser Mantis Laser Academy. I think it's pretty good. Maybe a few more improvements and updates, but it's a good start because it can adjust for the height over bore.